Hello everyone, it's Farkad here, and in this video, I'm going to provide you with the top 10 things to take into consideration when choosing a place to build. Now, this isn't a best place to build video. I will be doing one eventually, though I've played this game for about 1300 hours, and I've kind of realized that there is no real best place to build. The reason being is because we're all individuals, and we have different criteria for building. For example, do you want to engage with enemies or do you want to build in peace? Is a great view of your surroundings important to you? And do you need a lot of logs for what you're planning, etc.? Though I've got a list that I've devised to help guide you on finding a place to build. There's 10 of them. Treat it like a checklist. I don't think you're going to find a place that's going to meet every single criteria, though the more you check off, the better time you're going to have and it's going to be more enjoyable for you. And without further ado, let's get started. Now the first one is sticks. This is one of the biggest ones. The amount of sticks you need in this game is insane. Log carts can only carry 58, which can make it tedious to transport them, even by boat. The game doesn't currently have the luxury of using the zipline to transport sticks like logs do. There is about 61 items and buildings in the game that require sticks. Sticks are needed for almost everything in this game, and that includes traps. If you don't have sticks, your traps won't work. You need them for fires, storage, and many other things. I made a video a long time ago covering the best areas for sticks. I recommend checking it out, but here's a map of it anyway. Green means good, yellow means okay, orange means it's not very sustainable, and red means there's no sticks. This is the biggest issue with islands, so they don't have sticks, so you have to bring them to the island. But boats are good for that. Number two is patrol routes. This is highly dependent on the type of game you want. I've made patrol route videos and a patrol route map. I'll show it on the screen. I have personally noticed this game has a very different feel when you're building on a patrol route because you get attacked a lot more and it can distract you from what you're trying to do. If you're looking for a peaceful build or you want to focus on building, you're probably not going to have that luxury if you're on a patrol route. It also ramps up the difficulty if you're on a patrol and it can be frustrating at times. You will be distracted a lot more and the game will be more about action than building, though it depends on what you're trying to do. I do recommend building on a patrol route once you've got a bit more experience, as it can be a lot of fun, though build in a spot that is suitable for the type of game you want to have. Now this patrol map covers almost every route. The top parts of the snow haven't quite finished, though it is very accurate. Number three is natural defenses. This is hugely important. I stuffed this up in my season 2 playthrough because I build out in the open. When you build out in the open, you've got to defend so much more and it becomes very frustrating. If you build in an open area, you can be attacked from all sides. And personally, this is one of the most annoying experiences in the game. Though find natural defenses. This includes cliffs, water, and try and have your base against one or more of those things. And that way you only have to defend for one or two spots. You can technically make your own natural defense using water collectors as they block them out. Though they have to be quite close to your base, otherwise they spawn out. They're currently invulnerable as of version 1.07. I don't know why. Number four is logs. They are easier to get than sticks, but if you're planning on building a village, a mansion, or something else that's massive, you're going to need a lot of them. So it's probably best to build next to a large stockpile. I don't have a map with all the trees on it, though trees stand out pretty obviously. You can see where there's a lot compared to when there's not. The top half of the map is quite stick and log deprived, just letting you know. It is much more difficult to build up there. Number five is, does the area visually appeal to you? Now this is a very individualistic thing. It has no real effect on the game, though if you don't like the look of where you're building, it can really discourage you from building there. Also take into consideration the debris and boulders. A lot of those things can block what you're trying to do, or just give it an unappealing look. An example of this is next to Geese Lake. There's heaps of shrubs and small bushes right next to the lake. It can be quite unappealing, but that's just my personal opinion. Having a good view can make it much more fun to build. Number six is a water source. It is good to have a water source nearby because it's useful for washing off blood. There's no other way unless it rains currently. They can also provide fish, or you can build a dock and have access to your base via a boat. This can be good for bringing in materials and to break up the game from using zip lines all the time. Fresh water can also be important. If you have a fresh water source and you like stews, it can be a lot better. You can just use dirty water to make the stews. In my experience, I have played games where it hasn't rained for 10 days. This can be frustrating. Though keep in mind that nearly every pond crosses a patrol route. So if you're going to build next to a pond, you're most likely going to get more visitors. Number seven is stick trees on build spots. Now, I'm pretty sure they haven't fixed this, but when you build over a stick tree, every time you save and reload, the stick trees will respawn. And if they're through your base, it can be extremely frustrating because they'll spawn through your floorboards and it can give it a crappy look. And a lot of time you'll have to go underneath the floorboards to actually get them. You can plant a garden inside your base to make it look more realistic. That's something you can do. Though in multiplayer, if you've got stick trees come through your base and you clear them all and you want to show off your base, the other players will see different stick trees to you. So they'll be able to see the stick trees even if you've cut them down. So it's not a cool look. So I recommend building somewhere where there isn't a lot of stick trees underneath your base. If you're unsure, save and reload beforehand and then you can see because they'll respawn. Number 8 is sea level. This one might seem odd, but if you like zip lines, this is going to seriously affect you. If you build high above the sea level, such as the snow biome, it will be much more difficult to bring logs into your base. However, it will be easier to get out, though bringing materials in is more of a priority personally. If you're high above sea level, you could always use a turtle shell to sled out of your base. If you want the best solution, build close to sea level. That's why building next to the ocean or the river can be a good idea. Number 9 is rabbits. If you're interested in catching and breeding rabbits, then building an area near them will make it a lot easier. You can monitor your traps while you're building. Rabbit cages can be built on boats and transported across water, though currently if you build inland, you will have to carry each rabbit individually one at a time, and if you're far away from your base, this can be very unpleasant. I got a video on catching rabbits. You can use a small raft and build rabbit cages on it and push it along the land, but it's so easy to pick one up and drop it by accident. If you have a place where you like to get logs, set up traps around there. Might be a good way to catch them. Though moving rabbits is really boring. Though if you want to overcome this an easy way, it's a little bit of a cheat. Turn on console commands, developer mode on in the main menu. Once in game, type in add item 77. It spawns a live rabbit. Then you can just place it in your cage. It's an easy way to overcome that one. Once you get enough, they'll just breed and you'll be sweet. And the final one, number 10, is other important items. Items such as rope and cloth can be extremely useful, especially if you like using a zip line or bone armor. Having these nearby will save you a lot of time. Essentially, have places where it's good to raid. Some caves have some nice stuff in it that respawns. The main cannibal village is a good one to be near, though there are other spots as well. Anyway, that's my list. If you have any more that you would have added to the list, let me know in the comments. I will be doing a video covering more better places to build. I've never done a video on it. The reason being is because it's such an important thing, and I haven't built everywhere, so I can't really class a place as good to build if I haven't built there. The only way you're truly going to know is to build there for like 50 days. I recommend using the forest map as well for picking a place. You can see where animals spawn on there. The patrol map and the stick map are also used off the forest map. You can use them as a guide. Anyway, if you like this video, make sure you like and subscribe. Cheers.